Hi, Douglas Peacock here. Hey, thought I'd share with you a couple of tips to help you when you're trying to create things in your life or to in your health on achieving that ultimate game of getting yourself back and out of disease and into total health. You know, one of the things that we look at is the power of the belief and power of the mind that we can create anything in our lives, our imagination. If we can imagine it, we can create it. Yet, why doesn't it happen? And, you know, the question I get quite often get asked is, you know, well, I'm wanting to be healthy, but it's not moving. And then that's why I go in and do what I do. But the thing for you that I want to share with you here, it's the power of our belief. It's in the power of our belief that we are XYZ, that we create it. Now, a great example of it is people that can walk over hot coals. Here they are, they're going along and they walk over these hot coals and they don't burn their feet. Yet some people, when they're doing the same exercise, they get a burn on their foot, their feet will burn. And yet they've had the same training beforehand, they go about it, and certain people walk, most of the people walk across, not a problem, the odd person does. What happens? Now, it's a key minute distinction here is that if you've got a belief that you can walk across those hot coals, and yet for a moment, a split second, you get that doubt and, oh, can I? In that moment is where you'll burn your feet because your frequency shifts. And it's in that that the doubt creeps in and then it, the burning of the feet happens. So, you know, people test this to all sorts of levels. There's religious groups out there that test it. You know, these are the guys that you see with cobras and, you know, these they're not worrying about the getting bitten by the venomous snake, and you know they just play with them, you know, just like you play with a cat or a dog, you know, whatever. And they're totally fine. And if they get bitten, they don't get affected so much because their belief is so strong that they will not be affected by the poison. And there's even yogis that will drink arsenic poisonous. And don't die. It doesn't affect them. And you go, dude, how can you do that? I know for me, I drink that stuff, I'll be dead. And you know, so the thing that we look at is go, wow, well, what's actually really going on? And how can they have that state? And how can I get into sort of things like that, or states like that, and things that I need to believe? And so this is where we look at it in our life and go, well, hold on, what is it that we need to do? And so the key here is you must have 100% belief that you can achieve it. And it's in that 100% belief that you can achieve it that the end result will come through. You know, I've been blessed enough to have had the experience of being very, very ill to the case where I actually went home, died sort of thing, and came back. But because of a bug in my knee from an operation I'd had. And it was in the teaching on being total health, I actually had to heal myself. And the thing that came about it is the Western medicine doctors, medicines, couldn't work out what the bug was, and the medicines just weren't working. And I was just in this, for want of a better word, crap place. And so I had to go in and work on myself to clean the energy out to heal myself. And, you know, 2 years later, totally fine and all's good. But the point was, is when you have that single focus determination of this is it, then nothing else can come in. It doesn't mean it doesn't try. It fair batters you, much like when you're trying to walk across the hot coals. You have to have that single focusedness to be able to cross the coals. Now, what you do, a way to be aware of whether you have that ability to hold that focusedness is the question that you ask yourself is, so say it's you're wanting to be total health, or you know yourself as total health. So you go, I am total health. And you hear in the background, yeah, right, dickhead. And that's just what happens. But when you know yourself as total health, if you have one iota of a doubt, then you cannot accept that you are total health. And it's not right or wrong, it's just where you are. Your belief isn't 100% focused and solvent on being, yes, this is what I am. So if it's not like that, then the question that you ask yourself then on how to become like that is, can I accept that I can't accept that I'm 100% health? And when you can say, well, yeah, I can accept that I can't accept that I'm 100% health, what happens there is it stops the pushing and it stops the leaking of the energy. And what happens is it opens up to see where you're able to recognize where you've been sabotaging yourself, where you cannot hold the space of being 100% health. And in doing that, you set yourself free to actually become 100% health. And that's the process that you do when you want to get rid of any dis-ease, as you go in there and am I 100% health? Or if you want trying to manifest something, I am 100%, I am totally total wealth. I am total financial wealth. I am totally in love in a loving relationship. And if you hear in your voice in the back of your head or the emotion that it's not 100% true, because you have to be honest with yourself here. And when you can recognize it's not 100% true, then the question that you ask yourself, can I accept that I can't accept that I'm not 100% there? And in doing that, it opens and it sets you free. Then you get to be able to move into that place of totality, and you then will find the healing happens, the finances coming, the manifestations come. And it's because we're being honest with ourselves. So, hey, I hope this tip helps and you can use it in your life to adjust why you may not have been getting some of the things that you've been wanting to, and open you up to a greater level of awareness of yourself. So, hey, if you like this, hey, come join us on our Heal Your Life Facebook group, where we give away these sorts of tips all the time. Okay, my name's Doug Peacock. Have a great day.